In this session, let me discuss about the architecture of the Python in depth in the interview perspective. Normally, Python is a dynamically compiled. It means that in other languages, we will be declaring the data type. Whereas in Python, the values are dynamically declared. And it is called as a dynamically compiled language. Even though we say that Python is a interpreter oriented language, again, the interpreter makes use of a compiler. Hence, Python is a interpreter compiler oriented programming language. Thinking about the interview point of view, while we study about the Python workflow, we need to know some terms that makes the Python more efficient, and while digging much, we'll get more answers regarding that. One among such questions is like, what is the use of intermediate bytecode, or why Python is platform independent? When you would have watched the previous episode about the Python workflow, if not, please look in the above card, you'll be getting it. Yeah. So in the Python workflow, I would be explained about the Python interpreter, how it actually works with lexing, parsing, compiling Python virtual machine. So this Python virtual machine is capable of making the Python as a platform independent one. But how it actually makes the Python as a platform independent? Let's look into this particular statement. Compiler generates intermediate bytecode such that the interpreting Python virtual machine PVM acts as a execution engine in processing that bytecode, which is a .pyc compiler generated bytecode by line, and generates the machine code that the particular machine architecture can understand. Compiler generates intermediate bytecode such that the interpreting Python virtual machine PVM acts as an execution engine in processing that bytecode line by line and generates the machine code that the particular machine architecture can understand. Hence, Python virtual machine, when it processes the .pyc file generated by the compiler, it executes line by line such that it acts as a execution engine for that particular machine where the program actually runs. It analyzes its architecture and it generates the machine code such that that particular architecture of a machine can execute it. So that is one of the most important salient feature of a Python virtual machine, which acts as an execution engine in converting a bytecode into that particular machine executable machine code. So again, we know that Python is an intermediate interpreter-oriented language such that it executes line by line. When it executes line by line, only if there is an error in a particular line, the program gets stopped. Until then, it gets executed. For an example, in all the other programming languages, we don't get the complete result if there is an error in a program, because the compiler-oriented programming languages compile the entire source code and then they execute the result. Whereas Python, it executes line by line. For an example, A is equal to 100, B is equal to 1, C is equal to 4. Now I'm printing A, B. Instead of C, I'm printing D. There is nothing like D. I don't declare a variable D, and there is no definition for D. So it automatically throws error, but the output of A and B will be executed. So that is the significance of the interpreter oriented language. Actually, it is taking some time. I think it's loading there. Now we can see the output of A is 10, output of B is 1, and D is not printed. So what it throws, like, D is not defined. And next one is like, what is a Python virtual machine? Previously we answered for a question why Python is a platform independent variable. Python is a platform independent programming language. Here we're going to stress about the Python virtual machine. A PVM can convert the compiler generated object code .pyc into a machine understandable machine code. It allows us to work with multiple projects of Python that functions on different versions, such that the folders can be created based on the different versions we work, and different virtual environments can be created and dependencies can be installed. This line is very important because within this one Python tool, say Anaconda or like Visual Studio, any Python tool that we work, for different projects, we need to work with different versions. So every time we cannot download a particular version. So we have something called this Python virtual machine, which is capable of creating different folders, and in that particular folders we can download the dependencies. One project may require some dependencies, some other project may require another dependencies. Dependencies are nothing but the libraries or the important modules that you are required to perform that particular project, and that particular project may be working in a different version. So working in a different version is possible using this Python virtual machine. So within a single environment we can create multiple environment, that is called as different versions of Python can be executed. So that is one of the salient feature of a Python virtual machine and the major difference between Python and other programming languages like say C, C++, Java and Python. They are only compiler oriented. It is a compiler plus interpreter oriented. Normally a compiler oriented programming languages, from the source code it goes to the compiler, it generates object code, and they have something called a linker concept in order to execute that file. Whereas in Python there is no such extra feature is required, and comparatively a compiler oriented programming languages are little fast than the interpreter oriented language because it compiles the entire source code and gives the output at a moment. Whereas Python takes line by line execution, so the time taken by the Python is eventually comparatively low comparing to the compiler oriented programming languages. And secondly, still we have some more libraries. Using that libraries again Python execution can be made faster. And compiler oriented programming languages are platform dependent. They depend on the particular architecture and they work only on particular particular architecture of a machine. Whereas since this Python virtual machine is available, that contact software is available inside the interpreter of a Python programming tool, it is acting as a platform independent. So it can work in any platform. Python virtual machine can convert the compiler generated bytecode into a machine executable machine code such that it suits to work in any architecture. And elaborate codes and increase time. So normally in C, C++, Java, a single, like in order to, even if you define an integer, you write int a is equal to 10. But here the number of coding lines are very less in Python programming, and it has n number of libraries comparatively high in comparison with the other programming languages. So elaborate codes and increased time for other programming languages. For Python we have reduced codes and less time consumption. And an example is C, C++. Here we have Python, JavaScript, all these are like an interpreter compiler into programming language. And other programming languages, they require variable declaration, that is a static language. They are statically declared, as we know, while declaring the name of a variable we are declaring the data type before that particular variable. Whereas in Python we don't do that, we do dynamic declaration. And other programming languages, they have pointers to denote the location of memory address. Here we don't have the concept of pointers and they are limited in libraries. In Python we have more than 1000 libraries. That is why it is helpful to implement various tasks in various domains and in various branches of education. So that is the salient feature of Python once again. And again, other languages are platform dependent and Python is a platform independent. So it does not depend upon any particular platform, but independent, it can work in any other platform. So these are all the most important concepts of Python in comparison with other programming languages. Why Python is something special, we can understand from this particular episode. So thanks for watching.